Hello everyone, welcome back to Altium Academy. I am your host, Zach Peterson, and today we are going to be looking at when you will need to make the switch from mechanical drilling of vias to laser drilling of vias. Now, if you're doing an HDI stackup, at some point your vias might get so small that they can't be mechanically drilled anymore, and you will have to plan for laser drilling. But if you do have to laser drill those vias, how does that affect your stackup design? These are very important things that you need to know if you're ever going to venture into HDI design, and that's what we're going to discuss in this video. We will also look at some of the typical manufacturability limits for laser drilled microvias. Let's go ahead and get started. Now, mechanical drilling is the standard process used to place holes in a PCB. You can mechanically drill blind or buried vias. You can also mechanically drill through-hole vias. And if you have a stackup, typically it's a multi-layer stackup, you will have some through-holes somewhere. They could be for components, such as through-hole components, they could be for mounting holes, or they could be as your vias. First, what we're gonna do is look at the manufacturability limits for mechanical vias. So, what are those limits? Well, the limits for mechanical drilling of vias really depend on a few things. First, we have an overall thickness for our stackup, and then we have a hole diameter here that we need to consider. And so for those of you who have watched some of our older videos specifically about things like IPC 6012, Class 2 and Class 3 products, you probably know where I'm going with this. The limit for manufacturability of mechanically drilled vias is based on the aspect ratio. And the aspect ratio, AR, is very simply defined as the ratio of T to D. Typically, when you have a 62 mil stack up and you have a drill diameter of, let's say, 12 mils, you're gonna have about a 5-to-1 aspect ratio. So that's a pretty safe aspect ratio to use in most products. Now, at some point, as you scale down these mechanically drilled vias, you will hit a manufacturability limit. And of course, it pays to know what exactly is that manufacturability limit, because that is going to limit the board thickness that you can use with a particular diameter of your drill. Let's suppose that we're using, for example, a 10 mil drill bit here. What is the aspect ratio limit? Well, it's going to depend on your fabricator's capabilities, but they are generally going to specify a value such as, for example, an aspect ratio of less than 10, or maybe even as low as 8. So 10 or 8 are pretty typical numbers here for the aspect ratio limits when you get down to 10 mil drilled vias. What about a diameter of 8 mils? Well, with an 8 mil mechanically drilled via, you may find that this aspect ratio also has to be, for example, less than 8, or maybe even a little bit less than 8. Now, what's the smallest mechanically drilled via that we can place? Well, the smallest mechanically drilled via that we can place is about 6 mils. That's a pretty small via, and once you get down to 8 mil mechanically drilled vias, or even lower at 6 mil mechanically drilled vias, you're gonna find that your costs start to go up because tool consumption starts to go up. They're gonna have fewer available drill hits for these very small drills, and so they're gonna have to replace those drills more often. Now, this is also going to limit your available range of possible aspect ratios. This may also force you into a situation where you are at an aspect ratio of less than, for example, 8. Well, at an aspect ratio of 8 with a 6 mil via, you actually can no longer drill all the way through a standard thickness PCB, because at this point, you're going to have a thickness of 48 mils, or 1.2 millimeters for the folks who use metric. So, these aspect ratio values have to be matched up with your drill size, even with mechanical drilling. Now, I have talked to some fabricators who say that they can do much larger aspect ratios than this, even with 6 mil vias. And so I think it's important to note that this is one of those things where you should contact your fabricator and look at their capabilities, so that way you know the drilling limits that you can put into your PCB. That's going to prevent any kind of potential redesign after your board goes through DFM, and it's going to ensure that you have high yield. So far, we've talked about the limits of mechanical drilling, but at some point, once you get down below a 6 mil via diameter, you are then going to have to switch to laser drilling. So what are the limits of what you can do with laser drilling? Well, once you're at a diameter of less than 6 mils, you will definitely have to do laser drilling. Now, you can still do laser drilling at, for example, up to 10 mils if you like, but the aspect ratio limits are different when you're dealing with these types of holes. Laser drilling has smaller aspect ratio limits, and that forces you to use different layer thicknesses compared to the case with mechanical drilling, where mechanical drilling can basically drill through a very thick PCB. So let's take a look at a type 1 HDI stackup here. So with a type 1 HDI stackup, we basically have a blind via on the outer layer. We could have a couple of inner layers here, and then we have another blind via here on this layer, and then it's all linked together with a through-hole via. These layers here that are placed with very small diameter vias, let's suppose that we have a diameter here of 4 mils, pretty typical value for a laser drilled hole. When we're laser drilling this hole, we're going to have an aspect ratio limit that is typically less than or equal to 1. So this is where we get a limitation on the layer thickness here for this dielectric. That is going to require that this layer thickness for this dielectric be less than 4 mil in order to be laser drillable. Now, you may know that a type 1 stackup doesn't just limit you to blind vias. You could actually have a skip via, so a via going from the top into this inner layer. Now, what about this skip via? Can it also be laser drilled down to, let's say, a 4 mil diameter? Well, if this thickness here is also 4 mils, then the answer is no. Unfortunately, we couldn't laser drill a 4 mil wide skip via all the way down to this internal layer because we have to obey this aspect ratio. What that's going to force us to do is then use a thickness here of, for example, 2 mils, and then we may have to use a thickness here also at 2 mils. That's going to ensure that this total thickness is 4 mils. That's going to hit this aspect ratio limit just perfectly, and then we can do laser drilling of this skip via. Now, in mechanical drilling and laser drilling, we actually do have some commonality because there are IPC producibility levels that will define the allowed tolerances on the position and hole size for these products. So we will have a positional tolerance here that defines how far off this drill hit is from the center line. And same thing here with the through hole. We could have a tolerance here that defines how far off this through hole will be from its top and bottom pads. So that's going to be defined by the IPC producibility level, and your manufacturer should specify their positional tolerances in their design guidelines, and that's going to ensure that you can hit a particular IPC producibility level. Now, that becomes very important when we look at the annular rings around these vias. Of course, each of these vias has to have an annular ring, which is basically the leftover copper around the top and bottom of these holes. That has to be some minimum amount in order to comply with a particular IPC product class. Now, IPC product classes also dictate some range of finished copper inside of this hole. So both of those things need to be specified if you are targeting a particular product class, such as class 2, class 3, or class 3A products. So to learn more about this issue with annular rings and IPC product classes, make sure to check out the related video in the description to learn more. Now, what are some typical limitations on laser drilling and mechanical drilling that we can see from some actual manufacturers? Well, let's take a look at an overseas manufacturer and a domestic manufacturer to see what they recommend. Now, we're going to look at a couple of manufacturer websites. Of course, this is not an endorsement by myself or Altium of these companies. The information is just provided for educational purposes. Make sure to do your own research and contact your fabricator before starting your design. So first, let's take a look at this page on MADPCB. You can see here I'm on MADPCB's glossary, and here they're defining what is the aspect ratio in a PCB. Now, of course, this is very important because that aspect ratio relates to their capabilities for mechanically drilled and laser drilled vias. You can see here where they've defined mechanically drilled vias, and you can see here all the way down at 6 mm diameter or 0.15 millimeters, you can see that the available aspect ratio has to be less than or equal to 8:1. So that basically limits you to a maximum PCB thickness of 1.2 millimeters. Now, like I said earlier, I've talked to fabricators that say they can do much higher than 8:1, but of course, you should always check with your particular fabrication house that you want to use before you start designing that into your board. Now you can see here, they specify all the way up to 0.25 millimeters, which is a 10 mil drill, and they're specifying a 12:1 aspect ratio. So that's pretty good. That can get you all the way up to 3 millimeters thickness. Now let's look at their microvia capabilities. Here, their smallest laser microvia that they can place is only 3 mils, and they could also place all the way up to a 10 mil via with laser drilling. Now, at a 10 mil via with laser drilling and let's say a 0.75:1 aspect ratio, that's going to be a 7.5 mil thick dielectric. So you can still laser drill those very large vias, but you can only do it through a sufficiently thin board as defined by the aspect ratio. Here they have some other limits that they put on the capture pad size and the landing pad size, and they list some other capabilities here, such as stacked microvias and the different types of HDI stackups that they support, as well as copper-filled microvias. So if you're going to do an HDI design, this is all very important information to get ahead of time before you start doing your design. Make sure you select a fabrication house that can fit your particular design capability requirements. Otherwise, you're gonna have to change all this stuff before you can put your board into production. And believe me, I have done that in the past, and it's always a pain in the rear. Now let's take a look at another set of specs. Here I'm on the Sierra Circuits website. Sierra Circuits has also done a very good job of listing their capability limits, as you can see here on this page. So here, their blind via capability limits are specified at a little bit smaller aspect ratio for their standard process. This is at 0.75:1. And then here you can see the minimum dielectric thickness and things like the pad size and the drill size. Now, as you scroll down here and you look through their through-hole limitations, you can see here that they don't actually specify a particular aspect ratio for through holes. They do specify a minimum drill size, as you can see here, it is 6 mils or 0.15 millimeters, but they do not specify the particular aspect ratio for those drills. So this is another thing where if you are going to use a thicker board, you should contact them directly just to check that they can place those 6 mil drills into a thicker board. Some manufacturers will specify that. Of course, we just saw that on the MADPCB website, but here on the Sierra Circuits website, they are not specifying that. Make sure to check out all of those capabilities before you start placing these vias into your design, and that way you will prevent any redesigns before you go into production. Thanks for watching this video, everybody. Make sure to check out the aspect ratio video in the description. Also, make sure to read the blog on this topic that is linked in the description. Leave your comments and questions in the comment section. We always love getting your questions and comments. And of course, if you leave a great question, it might end up in one of these videos. Last but not least, don't forget to call your fabricator folks. We will see you next time.